How you doing? Jerry Regula with McWane Ductile, and you're watching The Ditch Doctor. We get a lot of questions from professionals like yourself, out there in the field, working hard, and we have the answers. So you got me here reading the latest edition of Modern McWane magazine, which is a very insightful magazine, a lot of project profiles and good information, interesting things for water professionals to read. In particular though, in the back, there's a section called The Ditch Doctor. You'll see the questions and the answers to a lot of things that you wouldn't think happen in the field, but I guarantee you, things happen. So today's question is regarding a TR Flex spigot inserted into a Tyton Bell. Can you do that? Technically you can, but I'm going to talk about some reasons why that's not such a good idea. So where this comes into play is you have a section of a project that's not restrained. So you have Tyton pipe, and then you're going to cross over to your restraint section, which is TR Flex. So we're going to talk about how to make that transition from Tyton to TR Flex. Okay, so here we have our product drawing, and this is what we're talking about. The section of the project here is all Tyton. And eventually, we're going to have a valve or something over here, or a bend. In this case, it's a 45. So in this section, we want to go to TR Flex. So how do we transition from the Tyton here to the TR Flex here? So here we have our TR Flex display, which you can see is cut out for easy demonstration. We have the Tyton gasket. So essentially from here down is the same as a Tyton bell. The difference being we have the weld-on ring and the TR Flex restraint section of the pipe. So that holds it all together in a restraint situation. The weld bead on a TR Flex pipe is essentially in the same spot as the Tyton spigot stripes. And as you can see, the weld ring hits up against the face of the Tyton section of the bell. This is where it's a little different from a Tyton pipe in terms of deflection. So when this ring is up against the bell, it doesn't rotate the same as a Tyton pipe. So if you're going to deflect this pipe in that direction, the weld bead is going to get hit up against the face of the bell and actually pull on the other side. That's different from a Tyton pipe, where the pipe will actually rotate on the gasket and is not pulled in. So on a Tyton pipe, as you deflect that way, the spigot stripes on that side will go back into the pipe. So that's the difference between TR Flex and Tyton. So here we have a Tyton bell and a TR Flex spigot with the weld-on ring. As you can see, the spigot inserts into the Tyton bell just fine. But when we deflect the pipe, the weld's hitting on this side of the bell. So on the adjacent or opposite side of the bell, the pipe is actually pulling out from the Tyton. So it doesn't deflect the same as a standard Tyton joint. So the answer to the question, you have two options. First, and the best option, is to order a TR Flex bell by plain end for your transition piece. The second option is to cut the pipe just behind the weld-on ring. Standard field cutting procedures: bevel the pipe, insert the pipe straight just like you would any other time, and you're good to go.
Thanks for tuning in to The Ditch Doctor. I hope you've gained some useful knowledge today. Remember to look us up on the McWane Ductile website or subscribe to the Modern McWane magazine. So that's all we have for The Ditch Doctor today. And just remember, you have the questions, we have the answers.